Hey, it's TC with Reed Sports in Walker, Minnesota. I'm with my friend Justin. Today we're going to be going over some of the different options of cold weather boots to keep you warm this season.
So looking at this big beautiful boot wall here, got a lot of different options here I can see. You got some rubber over here, some pack style, a couple hybrids. Now the one that really catches my eye when we talk ice fishing, Grandpa's old style of pack boot.
I know the Ice King's been around for a long time and it's been a staple of winter boots, you know, across the nation. Looking at a couple of different things with, you know, pack boots in general is this waterproof bottom, something that, you know, you get insulation in the midsole to keep your feet warm. And the last big feature that I really like is that you can lace it up still and give yourself a good amount of support if you need to walk all day long.
Don't they have like a removable liner to them too? So in
case... Yep, the inside liner there, and they do make these of different materials. You got felt out there, you've got just kind of a foam, or just sometimes, you know, different layers to the entire boot here. Just something that I kind of like, that those layers help with stopping temperature from traveling underneath.
And we'll have another video that kind of goes into pack boots more often, like more detail. That'll be in the description below. Let's get into some rubber style. I know like on early ice, you got a lot of like glare ice and stuff. Is there anything to help with that?
Yes, actually. Just kind of showing a real quick cool feature. Some boots, they'll actually add on the bottom, if you see those blue specks down there, that's Vibram Arctic Grip. So Vibram Arctic Grip does help with ice traction, something that I really like. I did get a chance to actually use it, and I will say I was pretty impressed with it. But you know, the big thing that I like about the rubber boots is you keep your feet dry, more dry than really anything else you can get out there. The only thing that I would watch is you got to keep your feet from sweating too much.
And how do I keep my feet from sweating too much where just my socks are soaked at the end of a long trek out to the ice house?
Well, since you mentioned socks, that's one option. You could get into a, you know, a better wicking sock. The other thing you can do is get like a felt insole, put that in the bottom. Kind of similar to how those pack boots before use felt, just wicks that moisture away, keeps your feet dry. Dry feet equals warm feet.
Well, good. We got some other ones here too. These ones, other ones that really catch my eye are kind of be your hybrids. So what do we really got in features when you get into like these hybrids where it's like mostly like the life of a rubber boot meets a pack boot?
Yep. And kind of what I was just saying with the keeping your feet dry, just to, this is one to show it, but on the inside you can see there's a felt liner on the inside. So they've kind of combined pack boots with rubber boots. You can drill your hole while ice fishing and you know that you're not going to get wet at all, at least up to there. But then you do keep your feet wicked and keep them dry. That's what ends up giving these boots often a good rating, you know, up to 40 below for some of these. And that's just something that I like about those. But moving into like some of these other things, they keep the rubber boot style to keep your feet dry, but really thick separation between the bottom of the ice and your feet. That's going to be two giant features for keeping your feet warm out there. And that's why you see companies like Clam and Striker, you know, making boots specifically for ice fishing.
Now, do those go up into any like big guy sizes, like your 13s, 14s at all?
Yep, I do get up to 14 in almost every boot I got out here. And I do get up to 15s in some styles.
Now, that's a great feature because I know getting a lot of calls and stuff for people that need a big foot, big shoe to cover that big foot, hard to find. So glad that we got some options for them here.
I know Justin mentioned earlier that we have a video about the pack boots down in the description below. You know, you gotta make sure you also check out our in-depth muck boots and other rubber boot video as well.
Now, me being a big-time duck hunter, I wear my rubber boots for ice fishing, for hunting, just about everything. What's your favorite boot to bring out on the ice?
My personal favorite is going to be more this lightweight pack boot. You know, that's one thing that Baffin does really well is the lightweight. And when you're on the move, like I always am when I'm ice fishing, that's going to be a big thing for me. Still got the snow cuffs, good separation between the bottom. It helps wick that moisture away. That's got to be my personal favorite.
Also, probably would work pretty good for snowmobiling and stuff too, wouldn't it?
Very well. Actually, I've also used them for snowmobiling. Last year, you know, swinging your legs over and off the snowmobile all the time worked really well.
Now, Nelson really hates the cold. That's one thing he always whines about. What would be the best option for him to keep his feet warm so he's not, you know, just getting off the ice right away because it's cold?
Well, I know he gets cold feet, so he's got to go with this boot. There's nothing better for temperature. This thing is rated to negative 148 degrees. I mean, that's about as insane as it gets. And honestly, if he gets cold feet after that, I think he's got to move out of our state.
Excuse me real quick. Nothing to see here.
That'll maybe keep them on the ice finally.
Yeah.
So one other thing I've been thinking about is, do we have any ladies options?
Yep, we do. Actually, if you look right behind you there, you want to hand me that?
Yeah.
We do carry quite a bit of women's Baffin. So like I was saying, those lightweight options, the pack boot with the liners. But then also we do carry, you know, those muck boots, those traditional muck boots to help keep your feet dry this winter.
Those ones are pretty stylish looking too.
Exactly. A lot better than some of our plain stuff that we've got up here. There's an overview of the cold weather boot options. If you have any other questions, feel free to check the link in the description below. Otherwise, come into our store, talk to any of us. We'd love to help you out.
Or give us a call, 1-800-346-0019. We can help you out over the phone as well.